Hi everyone, welcome to my channel Concept Tech 2018. You are watching video series of microcontroller 8051, and this is the second part in the series of programming exercises of 8051. In the first part, we discussed three simple programming assignments, and this is the fourth assignment. The assignment is to write a program to input two numbers from the keyboard, add these numbers and display the result of the operation. Here we'll discuss two programs. First is for binary addition, and the second program will perform BCD addition. This slide lists the instructions which are used for addition operation. In all these instructions, one operand is in the accumulator, and the second operand which is to be added, it can be taken directly using immediate addressing as shown here, or it can be accessed from the register, or it can be directly taken from the memory also using direct and indirect addressing. The result of addition operation is stored in the accumulator. An ADDC instruction. This instruction is used to add carry with the operand. So ADD is without carry and ADDC is with carry addition. Now we'll discuss the steps or the algorithm of this particular program. So the steps are, first of all, we have to input two numbers. So first step is inputting two numbers from the keyboard. So a subroutine is already available at 0AC1H. This is the address at which the subroutine is written to read the operand. So we'll call this subroutine twice as we have to read two operands. The second step is to add these numbers using add instruction. The third step is to display the result on the LCD screen. So for display of the result, first of all, we have to clear the display. And for clearing the display, a subroutine is written as 1558H. So we'll call this subroutine. Secondly, the result which is available in the accumulator, it is to be converted to its ASCII equivalent to be displayed. And for that purpose, a subroutine is written as 0B77H. So we'll call this subroutine for ASCII conversion. And lastly, we'll call the display subroutine which displays the accumulator content, and that subroutine is written at 1591H. At the end, last subroutine is called to get the information about the key press, that is the fourth step. If we press space key, then program starts again. That is, we give two new operands for addition. Right, all these subroutines which are discussed here, they are built in the trainer kit for our convenience. Let's discuss the program here. The program starts at the address 3000H, that is the RAM location where we'll write the program. Here we have taken assembly language instruction, its corresponding opcode, and we have written the commands also. What particular instruction is doing, right? So we start with the calling the subroutine 0AC1H. This subroutine is used to read the first operand from the keyboard. Then the operand is moved to accumulator and it is also saved in register R2. Then we again call the same subroutine to read second operand, and this operand is again moved to accumulator. So first operand is in register R2 and second operand is in accumulator. So this first step is complete. We have read both the operands. Now we do the addition operation, that is the second step. So add R2, then we move the result to 4E00H. We have moved the result from accumulator to the memory, which is initialized at 4E00H, that is the step 2. Now in the third step, we have to display the result. So first of all, we clear the display as discussed before, that is 1558H. We call this subroutine. These steps from 3013 to 301D are used to display higher nibble. The result is displayed nibble by nibble because we have to convert individual nibble to its ASCII equivalent. So for displaying higher nibble, we take the result from 4E00H to accumulator. Then we end that result with F0H. F0H will keep the higher nibble and it will make 0 the lower nibble. Then we swap A, that is higher nibble is transferred to lower nibble. Then we convert it into its ASCII using B77H subroutine and then we display this nibble. Next step is displaying the lower nibble. We do the same operation again, except we do not swap the content of the accumulator. So we have completed the step 3 of displaying the result. Lastly, the fourth step is we call a subroutine at 0AA1H, which checks for the key pressed. It remains in the same loop till we press space key, whose equivalent is 20H, right? If we press space key, the program goes back to start, otherwise it remains here. And if it goes to start, it will again ask for the operands and it will add again and it will again give us the result. So this is the program for hex addition. Now we'll check the execution of this program. We have already entered the program in the kit, so we'll check the program using D instruction. Will give the address range from 3000 to 3035H so that we can disassemble the program or the instruction written. We'll check all the instructions one by one. All the instructions are written correctly. After checking these instructions, we'll execute the program and check the result. So last instruction, now we'll press G and we'll give the starting address, that is 3000H, and execution begin. It is asking for entering address. Actually, it is the general routine, so it actually is asking for the first operand. We'll write first operand as 34H, second operand as 56H, and it gives us the result as 8AH. Now if we press space, it again goes back to the first operand. So we are writing again first operand 44, second operand 44, and the result is 88H. So we are, this program has been executed correctly. Now we'll press reset so that it comes out of the execution loop. We'll write the same program for BCD addition. The program is exactly same, except we have one additional instruction which is written in bold at 304C, that is DAA, decimal adjust accumulator. What this instruction does, this instruction converts binary to its BCD number. Let's check the execution of this program. First of all, we will disassemble the program as we have already entered it. We have written this program at 3040H, so we are disassembling from 3040 to 3076H. It will show us all the instructions which we have written. All the instructions are exactly same except for one instruction, that is DAA, decimal adjust accumulator, which converts the binary sum to BCD sum. Now we'll execute the program using G instruction, G, and we'll give the starting address, which is 3040 this time. Begin execution, it is asking for the first operand. We'll write first operand as 34H as before, second operand is 56H, and this time the result is 90H. Again, it has come back to the same loop, pressing space, 40H first operand, 40H second operand, and it gives us the result as 80H. So the execution is done. We have seen the difference in the result while executing the program. For same input operands, 34H and 56H, hex addition gives us result as 8AH, whereas decimal addition gives us the result as 90H. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please like, share and subscribe my channel Concept Tech 2018 for more such videos, and keep watching this series to be an expert in microcontroller 8051. Thank you.